Welcome to Studio Biology. In this video, we are going to discuss the reproduction in frogs. It's very important to note that frogs lack any type of copulatory organs, but these perform an act of pseudocopulation, which is known as amplexus. So we can observe amplexus here. This is amplexus, during which the male frog sits over the back of female and sexually excites it. And then both male and female frogs will release their gametes into the water for external fertilization. So in the life cycle of a frog, these are adult frog that will form amplexus, that will perform amplexus, and after amplexus the eggs are released into the water. External fertilization will occur, and after external fertilization embryos will be formed. These will develop into tadpole. The tadpole will develop legs. First two legs will grow, then further two legs will grow, and a tetrapod tadpole will finally develop into a young frog under influence of thyroxine hormone. It requires iodine in water, and finally this young frog will grow to adult frog. Breeding season is rainy season, and the process is amplexus, that is process of copulation. But it is important that as copulatory organs are not there, it is a process of pseudocopulation. Male and female frog discharge their gametes in water. External fertilization occurs in the water, and within 2 weeks of fertilization, tadpole will come out of the fertilized eggs or zygotes, and tadpole undergo metamorphosis because of thyroxine hormone, and finally it will lose the tail, grow in size, and become adult frog. It's important that if iodine is absent in water, then the tadpole will remain tadpole. It will not be metamorphosed into the adult frog. It will grow into a giant tadpole. Same case will occur, or same event will occur, if the thyroid gland is removed from the tadpole. Again, it will remain as tadpole, and it will not be converted to the adult frog. So this is all about the life cycle of a frog. Thanks for watching this video.